In Web 2.0, so we have a Web 1.0, Web 1.0, and Web 2.0. In Web 1.0, so here it is only small companies, advertisers generate contents which helpful for users to access, which helps users to access, and that too it is small companies. Whereas in case of Web 2.0, it's almost depends on the contents created by users. So it's indirectly depends on Web 1.0, but it is not important how much content is generated by users. So content is important. So Web 1.0, user access to the content, generation of the content. But when in Web 2.0, we are making use of the content, that is for sure. But not important how much content is being generated. It least bother about the contents, how the content is being generated by the users, how it is being generated. That is what we know about. Okay, so there are many other Google, like for example, we talk about Google search engine advertising company helps users in publishing their content on their website. Google is providing a platform for the users. Many other sites also provide the same, such as Flickr, MySpace, Wikipedia, and YouTube. These are all several different things which you need to generate. We need to generate. The next, when we talk about the architecture, it plays a significant role in developing softwares. So Web 2.0 helps in developing softwares. How? The type of softwares are called as open source softwares. That is the main key point you need to remember. Open source softwares are nothing but these are the software which are freely available. There is no need for us to buy. They are freely available. That is what we call it as open source. So for example, like Facebook, LinkedIn, Avatar, 3D virtual environment helps in communicating with people around the world. They are free of cost. For example, basically, you know, what is UFB? Facebook. It is a social networking where you can communicate with people. So you always feel comfortable in communicating with people with the software, which is a very free software, that is open source, we can say. Okay, so what are the representative characteristics of 2.0? How can we characterize them? So what are the main characteristics or representative characteristics or the main characteristics of the Web 2.0? What is the Web 2.0? One, so Web 2.0 becomes more popular and valuable when number of users increases. That's it. So as the more number of users, so how you can say one program is popular or one business is popular means people start knowing about it. People starts understanding what are the policies, means how the people work and what is the goodwill, what is the market rate, market share. We talk about, we think about all these. So that's the reason why we think means we talk about it becomes more popular and available when the more number of users users increase and ability in gaining the knowledge or ideas of the users also increases. So that is what we call it as more popular and valuable. More popular and valuable. Web 2.0. Next, it can be mashed up more oftenly via web service interfaces. Because we talk about web, so we talk about web service interfaces. Web service interfaces. Then next, it depends on user generated as well as user controlled data. It depends on user generated data and user controlled data. For example, if you stop uploading videos in YouTube, what happens to the video YouTube? It cannot get the data. Daily around 100 thousands of videos are being uploaded, millions, not even thousands, millions of videos are being uploaded into YouTube daily or hourly basis. Then what about that? If there are no contents are being shared, means the user generates the data and user controls the data there. Then it permits users to use any application completely. Permits users to use any application. Any application completely. The next, it mostly depends on social networking, social computing and social software. So we are talking about social network completely depends on the web 2.0 completely depends on social. We talk about social networking, social computing, social softwares. So this is what we talk about, social computing and social networking, social. So web 2.0, it's a revolutionary. In summary, we can say, if we want to conclude this, with web 2.0, it's as open source softwares available, where the companies used to generate data previously in web 1.0, that data is being used in the 2.0. And because least bothered about how much data is being generated. The main characteristics of web 2.0, it is popular and valuable. We are going to use the web service interfaces. The user generates data and user controls the data. And it permits the user to use any social networking applications or any application over the web. It completely depends on social networking, social computing and social softwares. So this is what we know about web 2.0. When we talk about another concept, like what is meant by virtual world? What is the meaning of virtual world? The virtual world is, just a moment. It is nothing but it's a technology which creates an artificial environment that responds to and controlled by the behavior of the user. I think you might have come across a virtual world, or we can say sometimes it is also called as virtual reality, where it is a simulated environment. Means, for example, it is like a gameplay virtual environment. It creates a graphical environment before you where you respond and accordingly the environment will get affected. Like PUBG game, it's a virtual world. And then next, air flight simulators, where you will be feel like you are in an aeroplane and you are learning. So that's what we call it as virtual world. It is nothing but it's a technology that creates an artificial environment. Just a moment. It's a technology creates an artificial environment. It creates an artificial environment which responds to and controlled by the behavior of the individual. By the user. So remember this point. It responds and controlled by the behavior. Controlled by the behavior of the user. So it is created. Why it is being created? It is created by using interactive graphics software. Yes, definitely. With special softwares. What you call it as. Interactive graphics software. There are specialized softwares. Like for example, we can say Bahubali movie. It's a virtual environment. It is actually those type of castles will never exist. But we we are under such an environment will be shown for us to take care about what such environment. So it is a some computer generated artificial environment shared by more than one person, even a large group like PUBG online game. It is being a computer generated artificial environment. Computer generated artificial environment. The next, in virtual systems, the users wear stereo goggles. Stereo goggles means specs, we can say. Stereo goggles and even headsets. I think you might not come across. If anyone has seen it, that is better. Or else you can go to web or YouTube. You can say stereo goggles and headset. You can have a video of that where you will be completely, your eyes and ears are completely enclosed. Means it is like a helmet. So where you have integrated goggles and headset integrated with it. Sometimes in virtual these virtual environments, the virtual environments is being used in education, mostly in education and in entertainment and even in scientific and business work. These virtual environments are used. Okay, so and in this we talk about mostly to, you may heard about one field called multimedia, one multimedia where it is applicable even in virtual reality. The technology, these technologies enable us to perform interaction with computer simulated environment irrespective of our physical presence. Means, for example, if you have a hand glove and you have a body sensors, according to your movement that is being recorded into the virtual environment where your movement is being recorded and it is not, it is being analyzed, and in that game it responds according to your movement. That is what we call it as dynamic environment. So this was mostly utilized by education and scientific environment, education, entertainment. Then next one, where the most popular is Facebook, is mostly used in social networking websites where they are connected, millions of users are being connected. They are sharing their views and they are even, they share so many, the communication is they share the data, they share videos and they share the valuable information. So that is what we need to understand in virtual world we are trying to connect with. Then next, when we talk about the cloud services, which is also very famous, like Amazon Web Services cloud, Amazon cloud. So where we have technologies such as MySQL and PHP, Linux and Apache, they are collaborated with, they are collaborated with they handle the operations like news feeds, notifications. These are some of the tools which are being used in virtual environments. So they are physically, you might not be before a person, but you are trying to interact in a virtual world. So that is what the main focus is on about. Virtual world is nothing but it's a technology which artificially creates an environment for you. So that will dynamically affect your behavior and your responses. So it is mostly of an interactive graphics software, and it is sometimes it is computer generated artificial environment where it can be achieved with the help of hardware, that is stereo goggles and a stereo headset. So this virtual environment or the virtual world enable in education applications, entertainment, scientific and business world. So the most popular one are Facebook, and there is even cloud applications which are being used from time to time.